Hey guys, hope you're doing well. My name is Brandon, and today for what I like to call Tech Tip Tuesday. I know that's kind of corny, but it just rhymed with me, so I just rolled with it. But today I want to talk to you about some ideas for small church lighting. As far as stage lighting, this is really not about the LED, you know, colored lights for certain things. This is more like for your whitewash lights and different things like that for your church services. And the other stuff will come in another video. But I just want to show you some ideas if you have a small church and you know, you're looking for some different lighting ideas. This stuff may work for you. But you know, if you're a larger church or you have a much larger building, then these ideas may not be the best idea, or you can just kind of feed off of them. But I'll tell you why I got the things that I got. For the sanctuary that we're in right now, it holds about 225, and it has got basically four sections, and basically the ceilings are about 15 feet tall. And so this works kind of well for us. As a matter of fact, we had to actually reduce some of our lighting when we started live streaming because it was kind of washing out too much on the faces and different things like that. And we're still adjusting. We have a long ways to go on all of it. And you know, we have a shorter ceiling on the stage because the stage is higher, obviously, so we have a shorter amount of space to work with, but we're also trying to not have the lighting go on the screens. And so anyways, we're still working on all of our stuff, but I just want to show you these things real quick. First off, one of the first lights that I ever bought, stage lights, was a PAR 38. And I bought these when I was like 20. And the reason why I bought these, basically, the general regular lights, halogen lights that they had, are PAR 38s, PAR 56, PAR 64. That's basically how big and how bright the bulbs are and different things like that, or the light fixtures are. And those were kind of the general main ones. There are smaller ones, which I'll show you some of those in just a minute. But the reason why I chose the PAR 38 back in the day is because I didn't know a whole lot about lighting. The cool thing about this is you can get the bulbs straight from Walmart or a big box store, and they'll fit right in there. The other ones you have to get, you know, from somewhere else that you may have to special order them or something like that. But I like the fact that when a bulb went out or something like that, I could just go to a store, pick it up easily, put it in, and it's no big deal. And the thing of it is currently right now in our sanctuary, we have, I think, about eight or nine of these. And now you can actually switch them out. And I kind of prefer these right here that kind of have the outdoor glass type look on them. But right now you can get LED bulbs as well. Now, I'm not an electrician. It may not be the right way. I'm just telling you what we do and what I've done. And so if your church burns down, I'm sorry, but that's not my fault. Just giving that little disclaimer, but this has worked well for us. We've done this for several years with no problems. Every once in a while, we'll have an LED light flicker. Like we have one right now that's kind of flickering every once in a while for our services. But I honestly don't know. I haven't got a ladder and gotten up there lately. I don't know if it's just a loose bulb or if the bulb's going out. But that's just something you may want to consider. But the halogen lights work as well. They're just a lot more hotter in those kind of things. And so PAR 38 is a great choice, and that's a good one. The one I just bought, we actually haven't hung things up yet, and this is a PAR 20, and this is how big it is. It's not very big at all. And the reason why I got these is because I have been looking high and low for the PAR 38s with a barn door that didn't cost an arm and a leg. And if you don't know what a barn door is, it's basically this right here. And wrong way. And you can kind of block in the light certain ways, because on our stage we have two projection screens that are pretty large and right up against where our worship team is. And I'm trying not to wash out the screens as well. And so I was looking for some that had barn doors, and I really couldn't find any, but I was able to find these on Amazon and I believe BH Photo, which, by the way, I'll put the link to most of this stuff in the description. So if you click on the title, if you're on a phone, it'll pull it down. But you can look at the description and find all the links for this kind of stuff. And if you order through there, it helps me as well. But anyways, this is a PAR 20. And to put the bulb in, which this is the bulb I have in there right now. It's just an LED bulb. And I think I went back and got the PAR 16 bulbs because I guess I was just having a blind moment, but I wasn't able to figure out how to get the bulb down in there. I know some of y'all are probably like, wow, he needs help if he couldn't figure that out. But what I didn't know is you can actually unscrew the top half of this by undoing this silver part on both sides, and it releases it, and you're able to put the bulb on and then slide it right back over. And I just couldn't get my fat hands in there. And so anyways, I went back and got smaller bulbs, which it doesn't matter. They're working quite well for us. And so once you put it together, put it on there, you know, you just mount it from the ceiling. You can get C-clamps. If money is really tight, you know, you can mount it certain ways with just some iron and some nuts and different things like that. But the barn door is definitely a help, especially if you're dealing with the kind of the situation that I mentioned earlier. And so that's a good option as well. Right above me where the camera is right now, we have two par 38s coming down. And there's some other lights on in the building, but mainly right on me right now is two par 38s. And the thing about those are we did have three up there, and like I said, it was washing it out way too much, and so we took one of them down. They make, I think, 90 watt bulbs and 65 watt and 50. I wouldn't go with the highest par 38 bulbs that they make as far as wattage. You know, usually you think more brightness and all that kind of stuff, but you don't want it so concentrated, especially if you're live streaming. All right, so once you have the bulbs, another thing that you'll have to have is a, if you want to hook them up right now, you can put them on a switch and basically turn them on and off. But if you want to be able to dim them, and that's another thing, when you pick out bulbs, make sure they're dimmable bulbs. But you'll need a DMX controller. And this is one that most of you will kind of see, especially if you're a smaller church. They make bigger ones. They make the ones that are on computers and different things like that. But this is just a generic one. And it's basically got eight channels here, and you can flip it, and it has another eight channels. So it's basically 16 channels. So you'll need a DMX controller, and then you'll also need a DMX dimmer. And I'll put a picture of that on the screen right now. And it basically has eight different outlets on there, but they're in sets of two. So you can plug two lights into to channel one, two, and three, and four, basically just two per channel. And that's channels one through four on your DMX controller. And then you can just keep adding on, and you can daisy chain them off. You are basically on the bottom of it, it's got a three pin cord place where you can put it. Cord place, that sounds horrible. Basically where you can input it looks like an XLR cable, a mic cable. And you know, they make specific cables that are called DMX cables, and those are recommended. I will tell you that I've used some cables from GLS that are just basically mic cables. They work just the same. I've had no issues out of them. And to be honest with you, that's what I'd probably use. And I'll put that link in there as well. It's just basically a generic mic cable. But if you're having issues, you may want to try a DMX cable. And I know the professionals or whatever may be sitting there going, no, please don't do that. But that's just my honest opinion. I haven't had any problems with it. But you'll need a light bulb mount if you want that, DMX controller, and a DMX dimmer. The DMX controller, I think, is around $100. And the DMX dimmer, which is basically the box that you also hang up with the light and plug the light into, is around $100. I found some back in the day around $80 to $90. And they go up a little bit higher to 126, and you can go kind of crazy with it, and they have bigger ones and all that kind of stuff. But just look at the reviews and different things like that. And like I said, I'll put a link to a couple of them on the page, but you can just kind of look on Amazon and see which ones would best fit your need. And I wouldn't recommend getting a huge DMX dimmer switch, just because if you have 20 in a row, well, then you're having to run extension cords to all that kind of stuff. And so I don't really recommend that. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment or subscribe as well. I'd appreciate that. And if you have any questions, I'd be happy to help you with that. Hope you have a great day. Thanks.